Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. At 9:59 p.m. local time there by San Jose and Morgan Hill, there was an initial 3.8 earthquake that was revised to a magnitude 3.6 by USGS. So far, 2,162 people reported feeling this earthquake. It was part of the Calaveras fault zone. You can see it drawn out in red. And I'll bring this out. Up here on the top right, we got San Jose. Right there. And then down here, we have Morgan Hill. This fault line moved south, and there was slight spreading to the fault zone. Most of the tension was applied going north. Many people said the felt reports lasted a few seconds. Many said their houses felt like they moved. As far north as Santa Rosa and as far south as San Simeon was the reports turned into USGS. The first report on EMSC was from San Jose. Said it was a quick tremor and was also a quick aftershock that could be felt. Another report from Alm Rock said bed shook for a good few seconds, felt the house move. Alm Rock, it says here, boom in Evergreen, south-north, San Jose. Or did they spell it wrong? At Seven Trees, they said there was a gentle roll. Another report from Seven Trees, definitely a good shake. Another report said felt a minor tremor. Windows shook. I suppose it would depend on what type of ground they were sitting on. Another said it was a pretty good jolt. Another report from Seven Trees says quick little shake that felt more like something exploded at the side of my house. Another report. So Seven Trees is about 12 miles from where the earthquake occurred, and it says here, there was a loud noise like someone slammed the door. Felt a large jolt, then light shaking, but yet another one said they barely felt it. Like I said, it depended on what type of soil their home was on. Another one said sharp jolt lasting 1 to 2 seconds. Another one from Morgan Hill this time says a big jolt. We are okay. Another report from Morgan Hill felt like a rolling one hit twice. A few minutes later, there was a magnitude 2.4 aftershock. It was 5.8 kilometers in depth. That would be about 3.5 miles in depth. 49 people reported feeling that earthquake. Same fault line. You can see here the location of the second earthquake. That one occurred at 10 p.m. local time. And on the 49 felt reports, we got San Francisco and Santa Cruz, what we got? San Mateo County. The waveform for the second one looks like it lasted maybe about 1 second of shaking. And here's another one that shows about 5 seconds of shaking. More likely, most people didn't feel it lasting that long. Another image of the wave of the earthquake that came in. And here we have another image of the different monitors. And here we have an image of the waveforms from that 3.8 that was revised to a 3.6. I can see how some people felt about 2 seconds of shaking. And then we'll come down here to the other waveform. Now this is for the 3.6. And then we'll come down to some other monitors that shows the earthquake. This one looks about 2 seconds, maybe. Definitely 1 second of intense shaking, but some of them lasted a little bit longer. Look at that. And we got it drawn out in seconds. We got 10 and 20. And then we'll come down here to this other monitor that shows the waveform of the earthquakes. Over here is the station numbers. Yeah, they got marked down here, the first wave of the earthquake, the P wave that I often talk about. And then afterwards would be the S wave. See the red lines there? That would be the first wave as it arrived there at the station. Now, for the aftershock, the magnitude 2.4, the second earthquake, you can see the fault line moved south, down towards the south. The first wave of the earthquake came from the north. Tension was applied going southeast. Many of these earthquakes that happen along this fault line, yeah, they do move south. Let me bring it out for you. Here we got Santa Clarita, Sunnyvale, Los Gatos, and Morgan Hill. So did you feel any of these two earthquakes? Did your animals, your pets, your dogs react prior to these earthquakes? Did you have damage? You very well could have some light hairline cracks to your foundation and maybe walls, and things definitely probably fell over and chandeliers and windows and doors rattled. Please put all that information down below. Thank you for watching. Always be prepared for a larger earthquake. Any earthquake has a chance of being a 20% chance of a foreshock for something much larger. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.